unlimited power. Jeez. That hurts my throat doing that. I did all of these effects with Filmora Pro. Want to learn more? Let's go.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
Filmora Pro is a completely different beast than the Filmora versions we've seen so far. This is where Filmora starts to pull out the big guns. The first thing you'll notice is that it doesn't have the traditional three boxes that we're used to. This one has five. Let's bring in a piece of footage, but before we add that to our timeline, we can view it and adjust it to find the exact part we want to work with instead of the entire clip. Filmora Pro gives us our own separate trimmer window just to handle this. I'll set the beginning and endpoints of the piece that I want to use from this footage, and then I can drop just that section into the timeline to continue. Now that clip will appear in the project viewer window, and Filmora Pro allows me to do several things. Instead of detaching the audio like we've done in other Filmora versions, we can just unlink the video and audio tracks and work on them independently. For now, I'll just work on the video portion. I'll need to find the spot where I want the lightning to start shooting out of my hand and stop the cursor right there. I can switch to the cutting tool, it looks like a little razor blade, and then slice the footage right where I want it. Next, I'll find the spot where I want the lightning to stop shooting out of my hand and add another slice. Now whatever I do to this section will start and stop right at those split points. Let's click on the new segment, and in the upper left dialog box, you'll notice an effects bar. I'll click on it and get a list of effects that I can add to this clip. I'll choose particles in simulation and lightning and electricity. This will add one lightning bolt to my section of footage with a plus sign on either end of it so that I can click it and drag it wherever I want the electricity to shoot from and where I want it to go. I'll put one end on one of my fingers and the other end I'll drag off the screen in the direction that I want the lightning bolt to shoot. In the effects dropdown, I have the ability to control the speed of this lightning bolt, the number of trunks, or how many separate bolts shoot out from that one finger. There's a wave scale of how wide the bolt jumps around, a twitch scale for how many little wiggles each bolt of lightning will have, and there is a blend dropdown which will allow me to tell Filmora Pro how I want this electricity effect to blend in with the footage of me waving my hand around like an idiot. I can go back to the effects menu and add multiple effects onto this clip. That way I can put more lightning bolts and have them all shooting out of separate fingers. This will make it look a bit more like the Star Wars Sith Lord that I'm clearly trying to imitate. Another cool effect I can add is under lights and flares. Let's choose the glow effect. That'll make it feel like the electricity is actually lighting up my face and the room as it shoots out of my hand. Once I get all of that where I want it to be, I can go back down and click on the audio track and actually add audio effects onto that track as well. In this case, I'll choose a little echo to make it sound like I'm more dangerous than just a guy in an old hoodie. Now, I'm using the trial version of Filmora Pro, so it's going to put the watermark over my final product on export, but you get the idea here.
Power!
You can pay for a license and then there'll be no watermarks whatsoever. Filmora, if you're listening, hook a brother up. So there you have it, Filmora Pro. I'll leave links in the description so you can go download it and check it out. Peace.